Hello friends, welcome to this episode of Science for Common Man. We all have noticed that our day sky is bluish and sunset is reddish. And you would have heard the famous four-word answer for this: scattering of blue light. And if you are not satisfied with this answer and want to know how exactly this happens and why it is blue and not green or yellow, and all in simple language with animations, this video is for you. Here we go. This is a beautiful night sky, and how do we see this bright moon? Sunlight is reaching the moon, and the surface of moon scatters that light, and some of that scattered light is reaching our eyes and we see it. Sun rays are passing through this region also, but we don't see anything there. Why? Because there is nothing there to scatter the sunlight towards us, so it's dark for us. Now see this beautiful day sky. Sun is here and this portion of the sky is blue. That means from there, something is sending blue light to our eyes. For doing that, what is available there? That should be the air in our atmosphere. And the air consists of 78% nitrogen and 21% oxygen molecules. So it should be done by oxygen and nitrogen molecules, and yes, it is. But why do they send blue light to us when sunlight falls on them? To know that, we should first know what is this sunlight made up of which make them react that way. The sunlight is made up of oscillating electric field and magnetic field, and so is called electromagnetic wave. Is it a single wave? It consists of multiple waves which have different rates and lengths of oscillation. The combination of these waves is what we see as white light. If we split them, we will see waves of different colors like this. Violet, blue, etc. have highest rates of oscillation and red has lowest rate, but all travel at same speed. Now let us see what happens when such a blue light is passing through a space where an oxygen molecule is there. The size of oxygen molecule is so less compared to the length of the wave. So, oxygen molecule starts feeling the variations or oscillations in electric field of blue light. If the size of the molecule was larger than the wavelength, it would not have felt the variations, and that is why the effect called Rayleigh scattering happens only when the molecular or atomic size is much lesser than the wavelength. Then, what if it feels the varying electric field? Inside oxygen molecules, 16 negatively charged electrons and 16 positively charged protons are there. Net charge is zero and distribution is also symmetrical. But when it is subjected to an electric field like this, positive charges are pulled up and negative charges are pushed down by this field. The charges get separated and oscillate like this. During this movement, charges accelerate and decelerate like this. Accelerating charges, that is something special, because accelerating and decelerating charges produce electromagnetic waves or radiations. The reason for that we will explain in detail in one of our future episodes. To move forward with this video, let us agree with the following facts. An accelerating charge produces radiation. The intensity of that radiation is highest in a direction perpendicular to the acceleration and zero in the direction of acceleration. And higher the acceleration of charges, higher the magnitude of intensity of radiation produced. Now, in blue light, the oscillation or the speed change or acceleration is higher compared to red light. So, the radiation produced by oxygen molecule under the action of red light will be less intense compared to that under blue light. Because of this acceleration dependence, the scattered light will be mostly blue and violet, where the frequency of oscillation is higher than other colors. Such a system where charges are separated by a distance is called dipole, and the radiation produced is called dipole radiation. This is the technique used in some of the antennas for production of electromagnetic waves. So what happens here? There is a light wave coming in this direction, and electric field of that light is oscillating in this direction. This induces charge separation, acceleration, and oscillation in oxygen and nitrogen molecules. That direction is also like this. As we know, these molecules now produce radiation and they will be mostly violet and blue. And what about direction? The intensity will be highest in this direction and zero in this direction. So, this light reaches our eyes and we see this part of sky as blue. But why not violet? In fact, violet has higher frequency or rate of oscillation compared to blue. And yes, violet is also scattered along with blue. But human eye is not that sensitive to violet light as it is to blue light. So, when violet and blue are received, our color senses interpret the net color as blue. If our eyes were not partial to blue, we would have seen the sky as violet. And another fact, the strength of this scattered blue light is so less compared to the direct light from sun. So, where sunlight is reaching us directly, we still see white light. What about the radiation which goes past the molecules? In the original light which reached the molecules, all colors were there. But the energy contained in the blue and violet lights were used by the molecules to produce their own radiations. So, the intensity of these colors in the radiation which goes past the molecules will be much lesser. If so, let's see what happens here, where we have sun here and we are standing here. The light has to travel through a longer path in the atmosphere to reach us. And during this travel, the blue and violet part of the light will be consumed and scattered away by the molecules. So, the light that reaches will be white light minus blue and violet. And if we take away violet and blue from white, it looks in this color. That is why we see sunset like this. And these clouds are in fact sending white light towards us, but we receive only this light. So next time, before looking at the sky, let's predict colors at different locations. That's it for today. Subscribe and be with us. Thank you for watching. Signing off, Science for Common Man.